Now entering the studio are today's contestants. Paul Moran, who works as a decorating contractor from Southampton. Joanna Bamford, a primary school teacher from Rayleigh in Essex. And our returning champion, Richard Thornton, a police officer from Silsden, West Yorkshire. And now, here is the host of Jeopardy, Steve Jones.
Yes, hello and welcome. Good to be with you back on Jeopardy again. We have more pounds to play for. And we're still looking for a five-day champion in order to give them that £500 bonus. One thing is for sure, though, as you know, at the end of the series, our top three scorers will be back, and they will be playing on that occasion for a fabulous 26-night cruise on Canberra. And we welcome back our champ from yesterday, Detective Constable Sergeant. I'm not quite sure whether it's a Chief Inspector, but he's certainly in the police force. Richard Thornton, who yesterday legally put his hands on £600. And challenging him today, we welcome Paul Moran and Joanna Bamford. Make them welcome, please. Okay. Right, the boys and girls, let's set the board in motion. I've got six categories in the first round of Jeopardy. £5 up to 25, as ever. The first one's poetry. Then famous puppets, tribal people, Hollywood greats, Asian geography, and T words. All the responses there, of course, beginning with the letter T. Three daily doubles again up there, hidden away. And don't forget, as you'd think, as the questions get harder, you win more money. But if you get one wrong, then you'll lose pounds. And you must give us the questions beginning with who or what, players. And remember, throughout the show, the only scores you'll see will be your own. Okay, Richard, let's have the first selection, please.
Famous puppets for £10, please, Steve.
Oh, and straight in with the Daily Double. A bonus in one way, a shame in another, of course, because you would like to have had, what, £200 or £300 in front of you. But you can, of course, place up to £25 in Jeopardy. How many will you go?
I got £25, please.
You'll have the full 25, okay? It's an audio one. Music on the way. First of all, your answer. Singers whose hits include this 1977 top 10 hit.
Gently down the stairs, Jesus dear, will I sit? There isn't any other stair.
If you're making your own rhymes up to that, please keep it to yourself, would you? Singers whose hits include that one from 1977. Richard.
Who are the Muppets?
Who are the Muppets? £25. Welcome aboard. Select again, please.
Hollywood greats for £15, please.
Wasting them away, but of course you have a chance now to increase the amount of pounds in front of you. How many are you going to place in Jeopardy, Richard?
£25, please.
£25 on this, okay. It's a visual one, so please, Mr. Wall, reveal all. There we go. Take a look at the picture then, Richard. A long, lingering look. Here's your answer. Oscar winner for the 1940 film Kitty Foyle.
Who's Jean Harlow?
Afraid not. And the £25 you won with the first double has now disappeared. Who is Ginger Rogers? That was Ginger Rogers up there on the wall. Okay, we're back. Everybody's playing equal. And Richard, you select again.
Hollywood greats for £20, please.
Answer. Actor whose best loved films include Harvey and It's a Wonderful Life. Richard.
Who is James Stewart?
Yes, you get £20. You're not the only person playing the game, I know. Okay, select another one.
Hollywood greats for £10, please.
Answer. Choreographer who co-directed Gold Diggers of 1933 and Footlight Parade. Paul.
Who is Busby Berkeley?
Yep, Busby Berkeley or Berkeley will do for me. £10 and welcome on board. Your selection now then, please, Paul.
Asian geography for £20, please.
Answer. Chinese River, also called the Huang Ho. Joanna.
What is the Yangtze Kayang?
I'm afraid you lose £20. Yes, Paul.
What is the Yellow River?
What is the Yellow River? £20 for you. Select again.
Asian geography for £25, please.
Answer. Largest city and chief port of Pakistan. Paul.
What is Karachi?
Yes. Oh, it is Karachi. £25 for that. Select, please.
Asian geography for £15, please.
Answer. Country of which the island of Bali forms part. Paul.
What is Indonesia?
What is Indonesia? £15. Select.
Asian geography for £10, please.
Answer. Himalayan Kingdom, of which Kathmandu is the capital city. Paul.
What is Nepal?
What is Nepal, Paul? You're quite right, Paul. Select another one, please.
Asian geography for £5, please.
Answer. Ocean in which the Philippines are located. Paul.
What is the Pacific Ocean?
What is the Pacific Ocean? Right the way through that category for you. A further £5 to your total. Select another one.
Poetry for £20, please.
Answer. Crimean War attack, which inspired a famous work by Lord Tennyson.
Paul. What is the charge of the Light Brigade?
Yeah, and you're on a charge at the moment with £20 there. Into the Valley of Death, road the 600, but you are now going to select the next one.
Poetry for £15, please.
Answer. English romantic poet, given names Percy Bysshe. Yes, Joanna.
Who is Shelley?
Who is Shelley? Yes, £15 for you. And another selection, please.
Poetry for £25, please.
Answer. English author of The Rime of the Ancient Mariner and Kubla Khan. Paul.
Who is Samuel Taylor Coleridge?
Yes, you've got all three of them there and £25. Select, please.
Poetry for £10, please.
Answer. Language in which the poets Ovid and Tibullus wrote. Paul.
What is Latin?
You are swift on that buzzer, there's no doubt. £10 for you. I don't know how many ducats that makes. Anyway, have another one.
I'll have poetry for £5, please, Steve.
Answer. Epic John Milton poem to which Paradise Regained was the sequel. Joanna.
What is Paradise Lost?
What is Paradise Lost? Okay, creeping back up there. Select another one, please. Joanna.
Famous Puppets for £20, please.
Answer. TV adventure series starring the Troy Tempest. Paul.
What is Stingray?
What is Stingray? You watched it as a kid, eh?
Yes, I did.
£20 for you. Select another one, please.
Tribal People for £25, please.
Answer. Nomadic tribes who inhabit the deserts of Arabia and the Sahara. Joanna.
Who are the nomads?
Can't give you that. Lose 25. Anyone else? Paul.
Who are the Tuaregs?
No, you lose 25 as well. Anybody else going to have a go? It's only Richard, of course, who's outstanding. Now, what are the Bedouin? Shame that. Okay, so two of our players lose £25. Paul, you're still selecting.
Tribal people for 20, please.
Answer. North American Indian tribe of which Geronimo is a member. Paul.
Who are the Apaches?
The Apaches is right. Okay. Speak with forked tongue and select another one, please.
Tribal people for 15, please.
Answer. People known in Canada as Inuits. Richard.
No, the Eskimos?
The Eskimos, yeah. They kiss with their noses. What a shame. It'll waste £15 for that. Select, please.
Famous puppets for £25, please.
Okay, here's your answer. 50 star who was accompanied by Annette Mills. Paul.
Who is Muffin the Mule?
Yes, everybody sing, but please don't, because we don't remember. It's £25 for that. Select.
Tribal people for £10, please.
Here's your answer. Continent to which the Maasai tribe are indigenous. Paul.
What is Africa?
For £10. Good again. Select, please.
Tribal people for £5, please.
Here's your answer. Polynesian people who constitute roughly 10% of New Zealand's population. Paul.
What are Maoris?
What are Maoris? Who are the Maoris? £5 for you. Okay, let's have another.
Hollywood greats for £25, please.
Here we go. Director and star of the classic film Citizen Kane. Paul.
Who is Orson Welles?
Who is Orson Welles? Yes, probably the best film and movie director in the world. Let's have another selection.
Hollywood greats for £5, please.
Answer. Versatile star of Sophie's Choice and Postcards from the Edge. Richard.
Who is Meryl Streep?
Yes, £5 for you. Select another.
Famous puppets, £15, please.
Answer. Fictional character who first appeared in Carlo Collodi's 1883 novel. Paul.
Who is Pinocchio?
That's great general knowledge there. £15 for you. Select another.
Famous puppets for £5, please.
Answer. Foxy glove puppet with the catchphrase, boom, boom. Joanna.
Who is Basil Birch?
Yes, you knew you'd get one eventually. £5 for you. Sweep into the next one, please.
Two words for £25, please.
Yes, it's the only category left, of course. £25, did you say?
Yes.
Right, here it comes. Elegant Soviet gymnast who was combined exercises champion at the 1972 Olympics. They begin with T, don't forget. Time is up. I'll have to read this. Who is Ludmila Turisheva? Okay. And she probably needed one as well, as most of them did around that time. Let us now have another selection, please, from you, Joanna.
Two words for £20, please.
Okay, here's your answer. Six Dorset Union members who in 1834 were unjustly tried and transported to Australia. Paul.
Who are the Toll Potter Martyrs?
For £20, and another one from the T words, please.
£15, please.
For £15, and this is the Daily Double. Without giving too much away, of course, to your two colleagues there, we can say that you have a substantial amount to play with here, Paul. How many pounds are you going to place in jeopardy on this audio Daily Double?
50, please, Steve.
50. All right. I can even bet. Music's on the way. Here's your answer. Singer who had a 1987 number one hit with this song. Okay, 1987, and the singer who had a number one with that, Paul.
Who is Tiffany?
Who was Tiffany? She sang in shopping malls, and you've got yourself £50. Well done. Whatever happened to Tiffany, but we know what's happening to Paul. He's selecting. Here you go.
Two words for 10, please, Steve.
All right. Construction of which the Simplon or Samplon is a famous example. Richard.
What is a tunnel?
What is a tunnel for £10? And it just has to be for £5 now. A T word. Island with which Trinidad forms a republic. Paul.
What is Tobago?
What is Tobago? You get £5. It's the end of round one of Jeopardy. He's pretty slick on the old buzzer there, isn't he, huh? Let's take a look at where we stand score-wise. In third place at the moment, it is Joanna Bamford. In second place, our returning champion, that's Richard Thornton, of course. And in the lead, as we head for the break, it is Paul Moran. And after the break, of course, we'll be in double jeopardy with twice the amount of pounds to play for. We'll see you then.
It's time to play double jeopardy, and it's back to Steve Jones.
Thank you, thank you. Yes, the heady heights of Double Jeopardy and Final Jeopardy beckon, but first of all, let's find out a bit more about our contestants playing today. Paul Moran from Southampton. Nice to see you here, Paul.
Thanks, Steve.
Very quick on that button, of course, in round one of Jeopardy, but I understand that there was a time in your life when you were very slow on a button during the holiday in New York, huh?
Yes, I got stuck in the lift at the Empire State Building.
What floor were you on at the time?
Something about the 53rd, I think. That far up.
I mean, you can't actually see out either from that.
Didn't really know what floor it was.
It must have been very claustrophobic, darling.
Well, I was in there for about 20 minutes, and it was full of Japanese tourists as well, which didn't help.
What was the atmosphere like?
Stuffy and noisy.
Yeah, but eventually, did they take you up or down?
They took us up eventually, and I was up there for a half an hour, and I had to queue for an hour to get down, and by the time I got back down again, I think my girlfriend thought I'd throw myself off the top.
Well, quite an adventure, that. I hope you're enjoying yourself today. Paul Moran there! Joanna Bamford, let me tell you a little bit about her. From Essex, a primary school teacher with three children of her own. So you're balancing career and that of home engineer at the same time, I suppose.
Yeah, trying to do a juggling act, that's right.
It's pretty difficult then, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
The nice thing, I suppose, being that your holidays coincide with those of the children, if they are of school age yet, aren't they?
Well, two of them are, but it's a fallacy. We don't get all the holidays that, we seem to have.
I know that. What is it, about 12 weeks per year or something?
Well, nothing like that. About half that, and you're about right.
Is that right? Yeah. A lot of that time, set the record straight, a lot of that time you're preparing for what's coming up in the next term.
Yes,
and going on
courses and all sorts of other things too.
Absolutely. Well, we wish you well in Double Jeopardy. Now, Joanna Bamford there. Richard Thornton, police force detective from West Yorkshire. £600 from yesterday. Good to have you back with us, Richard. You're a DIY man, I believe, yeah?
Well, try to do a bit at home, but not always successful.
Well, what's the least successful thing you've tackled around the house, do you think?
Nothing, really, because I'll only attempt jobs that I can do. Not any major disasters.
Oh, but what is it? A simple thing like hammer and nails, laying down floors?
Decorating mainly.
You're a decorating man. Okay. Well, we've decorated you with £600 already from yesterday. Who knows what will happen in a moment or two? Our returning champion, Richard Thornton. And right now, we return to the game, of course. We're going to play Double Jeopardy. Let's set the board in motion. Revolving around £10, up to 50 this time. And that first category, Olympic stars, books, faith and belief, pop star aliases, words and languages, and ships. Again, three daily doubles up there. And who's going to start for us? In third position at the moment, as we can see, it is Joanna. So, Joanna, select the first one, please.
Books for £40, please.
Okay, here's your answer. Joseph Heller's 1961 novel centred on the anti-hero Captain John Yasarian. Paul.
What is Catch 22?
And you've caught yourself £40 immediately. Select another.
Olympic stars for £40, please.
Oh! Right, okay. As we said before, you've got plenty. Are you going to place plenty into Jeopardy, or are you going to play a little cagey game like you did before?
A cautious 50, please, Steve.
A cautious £50 again, all right. It's a visual one, so we'll reveal all again, please, if you would. All right, there we are. You look at the man on the screen, I'll bring you your answer. Year in which that man won 4 gold medals in the Olympics. Year in which that man won 4 gold medals. Okay then, Paul.
What is 1936?
Yes, Jesse Owens, of course, in Germany, and you get £50 for that. Select, Paul.
Olympic stars for 50, please.
Answer. East German swimmer who won 6 golds at the 1988 Seoul Olympics. Who is Christine Otto? So the £50 go begging there. Select again, Paul.
Olympic stars for 30, please.
Answer. Sport in which Jean-Claude Key won all gold medals available to him in 1968. Richard.
Well, it's downhill skiing.
Yeah, downhill skiing, all sorts of other skiing he got there too. Yes, you get £30. Select another one.
Pop star alias is £30, please.
Okay, answer. 50s singer of Strangers in Paradise, born Anthony Dominic Benedetto. There was a big verbal clue there. Who is Tony Bennett? Yeah, okay. Select another one then, please, Richard.
Pop star alias is for £40, please.
Answer. Singer who had more to shout about after changing her name from Marie Laurie. Paul.
Who's Lulu?
Lulu. Marie McLaughlin Laurie, to give her the full moniker, but you're quite right, Lulu, and you get yourself £40 of that. Select, please.
Ships for 50, please.
Ships for £50. Answer. German pocket battleship which was scuttled off the South American coast in 1939. Paul.
What's the Graf Spee?
Graf Spee for £50. Select another.
Books for 50, please.
You have it. Answer. James Hilton's novel, which features the mythical land of Shangri-La. No, we're illiterate today. What is Lost Horizon? Okay, I lost £50 too. Well, not lost, but not won either. It's dormant. Let's have another selection then, please, Paul.
Faith and Belief for 50, please.
Okay, here's your answer. Religion of which the Mennonites form a sect. What is Christianity? All right, kids, I'll teach you some more later. And £50 goes in backing again. Select, Paul.
Books for 30, please.
Books for £30. Answer. Author of the thrillers The Day of the Jackal and The Odessa File. Paul.
Who is Frederick Forsyth?
For £30. Select again.
Books for 20, please.
Answer. Joy Addison's bestseller set in Africa, which became a hit movie. Joanna.
What is Born Free?
What is Born Free? Creeping back up again now. Select another one, Joanna.
Books for £10, please.
Answer. Cervantes' classic, whose hero sits astride his trusty mount, Rosinante. Joanna.
What is Don Quixote?
Yep, you get £10 then, and welcome back on board! Okay, let's have another one.
Words and languages for £50, please.
For £50. Answer. North European language for which we get the word smorgasbord. Joanna.
What is Swedish?
Yes, for £50. Select, please.
Words and languages for £40, please.
Form of Chinese, which is the official language of the People's Republic. Paul.
What is Mandarin?
What is Mandarin? Yes, you won £40 and a bowl of oranges. Select another one.
Faith and Belief for £40, please.
Right. Oh, another double you got. Well, if previous evidence is anything to go by, you've got to be cautious. But who knows, you might at this stage of the game wish to go for a big bet. How many pounds have you got to place in jeopardy then, Paul?
I'll have a big 60, please.
A big 60? Oh, you devil, you. Okay, well, reveal all. It's a visual one. Let's see it. Okay, nice picture. Here's your answer. Indian city in which this temple is found, Paul.
What is Amritsar?
Yes, it's the Golden Temple of Amritsar, Sikh temple, and you get £60. Select, Paul, please.
Ships of 40, please.
Ships of 40 on the way. Cunard liner, which made her final passenger voyage in 1968 and ended her days in Hong Kong. Paul.
What is the Queen Elizabeth?
Yes, it is. Right. You get £40. Select.
Ships of 30, please.
Answer. Country whose battleships Yamato and Musashi were the biggest ever. Joanna.
What is Japan?
Absolutely. £30. And you get another selection.
Words and languages for £30, please.
Answer. Language in which Buon Natale means Merry Christmas. Paul.
What is Italian?
It is. My accent's that good, eh? £30 of that. Less than a minute to go. Select again, Paul.
Words and languages for 20, please.
Answer. French name for a castle or large country house. Paul.
This is Chateau.
Qu'est-ce que c'est le château? £20 for that. Select another one, please, Paul.
Ships are 20, please.
Here's your answer. Ship which carried the Pilgrim Fathers to America. Paul.
Where's the Mayflower?
For £20. Select.
Olympic stars for 20, please.
Answer. Nationality of Fermín Cacho, champion in the Barcelona men's 1500 metres. Richard.
What is Spanish?
Yes, right. You get £20. Select, please.
Pop star earliest is £50, please.
All right. Yeah, now. Interesting. You know that we're nearly out of time. It's not that I'm going to persuade you which way to bet one way or the other, but how many of your precious pounds would you like to place in jeopardy on this audio daily double?
£100, please.
£100. Okay. £100 on it. Audio one on the way. Here's your answer. This Welshman ditched the name David Spencer.
Tell Laura I
This Welshman ditched the name David Spencer. Okay, Richard, what do you say?
Who is Ricky Valance?
Yes, you get the £100. Number one in 1960, that was. Okay. And we're out of time. That's the end of Double Jeopardy. Let's take a look at the score, shall we? We see that in third place we have Joanna Bamford. In second place we have Richard Thornton. And our current leader is Paul Moran. Well, now it's time to play Final Jeopardy. Yes, of course, this is where the players really are in jeopardy. Let me just remind you, there is only one winner. It's the player with the most pounds in front of them at the end of Final Jeopardy who will take their winnings home. Anybody's game, of course. Let's reveal the Final Jeopardy category now. Here it is. Science. Okay, so players, based on your knowledge of science, I'd like you to decide how many of those pounds you're going to place in jeopardy. And while you do that, here's David to tell us about the Master Jeopardy prize, that cruise on Canberra.
A luxury life on the ocean waves. That's what's in store for the lucky Master Jeopardy champion of 1993. There'll be plenty of sun, fun and relaxation on this luxury cruise for 26 nights to the world's most exotic locations. Jamaica, New Orleans, the gorgeous Bahamas. You'll follow the sun all the way on what has to be the dream holiday. An unforgettable journey of a lifetime.
Yes, indeed. Into that battle, Jim, and get Iron Apple. Right then, players, you've decided how many pounds you're placing in Jeopardy. Here's the Final Jeopardy answer. Vitamin group to which riboflavin and niacin belong. Okay, you have 30 seconds. Your time starts now. And don't forget, we want your response in the form of a question, beginning with who or what. Right, time's up. No more writing, please, contestants. Here's our Final Jeopardy answer. Vitamin group to which riboflavin and niacin belong. Let's start with you then, Joanna. £90. You have minus, you have plus, you have minus, you have plus, but £90 going into Final Jeopardy. What is your response, please?
What is vitamin B?
What is vitamin B? It's correct. And how many of the pounds did you place in Jeopardy?
£85.
85, taking you on to £175. A little ripple for that there. Returning champion won £600 yesterday, £200 in front of you, Richard, going into Final Jeopardy today. What's your response, please?
What is C?
Oh, sorry about that. That's all to be found in those citrus fruits, of course, isn't it? Anyway, it's wrong. How many did you place in Jeopardy?
200.
200. Zilch, was sorry to say, but of course you do have the £600 from yesterday. Now then, racing away throughout the show has been Paul Moran with £730 already. Your response, please, then, Paul.
What is B?
What is B? How many did you place in Jeopardy?
Poultry, 130, Steve.
130, taking you on to £860. Big winnings there for Paul Moran. He's our brand new champion. Therefore, we wave farewell to our departing champion. That, of course, is Richard Thornton. And also to Joanna Bamford. We say thank you for being contestants on the show. You don't go away empty-handed, though, of course. You have this fine consolation prize to take with you.
And Richard and Joanna take our compendium of popular games, consisting of backgammon, cribbage, dominoes, poker dice and cards, with the compliments of Jeopardy!
So, Paul Moran, our brand new champion, I've got a sneaking feeling he could go all the way. He's one rung up the ladder, of course, so he'll be on the second one tomorrow, seeing if he can win more money and then maybe stay on for 5 days and get that £500 bonus. It's all to play for on Jeopardy. Another edition tomorrow. See you then. Bye-bye.